everyone, Marianne here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a very exciting video for you guys because I'm going to be sharing what I'm packing in my hospital bag. This will be our second baby boy coming in about, I don't know, a month, a week, I can't really tell time. I'm in my 9th month of pregnancy, so I've got my hospital bag pretty much packed and ready to go. And it's just a bit surreal filming this for me. First, because it means like the baby's coming, but also because these were the videos that I was binge watching before my son Max was born, and that was the first time I was like, I really want to do YouTube. So yeah, it's just one of those like crazy moments, like here I am filming it for baby number two and everything, so life is crazy, y'all. So first, I wanted to tell you guys that aside from everything you see here, I also packed a bag for my son Max, like I mentioned, who's 2.5 years old, and my husband is packing a separate bag for himself. With Max's bag, right now I have it just hanging in his room, and I also have the present that he's going to be giving to his baby brother with that bag ready to go. And one tip I will say is that I picked out his coming to the hospital outfit, I put it in a Ziploc bag, and I labeled it really clearly, Max visiting hospital outfit, so that whoever's bringing him there will know exactly what I would like him to wear. The other quick tip I have if you're preparing for baby number two, although I think this would be great for your first kid as well, is I made a bunch of checklists and printed them out and put them on a refrigerator. And they have all the things like doctor's information, last minute things to grab before going to the hospital. I'll try to insert some photos so you can see, but basically they're all the things that I can't pack or take care of right this moment, but I wanna make sure not to forget in the moment. We also have two dogs, so they need to be cared for, and our situation with like exactly who's taking care of what and where those people will be just kinda depends on exactly when I go into labor, which of course I don't know when that will happen. So having those lists printed out in our kitchen for anyone who walks in to see just gives me peace of mind that they'll be able to know where everything is. And before I jump into all of this, I just want to let you guys know that I will have links in the description to anything I can. So if you're interested in buying the same thing, you can click those links and find them. And yeah, I hope you guys like this video. If you do, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up, and I would love it if you subscribe to my channel. Okay, so let's jump in. The first thing I want to mention is the bag that I'm going to be taking. So my plan is to take this. This is a Le Sport sack, what do you call it, like a carry-on duffel bag. And I'm hoping it'll fit everything. I actually have not packed it all in yet. I'm gonna do it at the end of this video and show you guys. So fingers crossed it all works. So for actual labor and delivery, I'm not bringing too much. All I'm bringing is organic castor oil. This is something our doula and midwife recommended. It's to help stretch the perineum. I won't get into the details of exactly how that works, but let's just say having some like a lubrication down there can be helpful for stretching. Okay, then the next thing for labor and delivery is actually something we purchased from our doula. So I don't know the exact name of this. This one is called an OB-TENS, but basically if you've ever had physical therapy, there's like this component called like electric therapy kind of thing. And basically this is a remote, and you put these like patches on your back. I can't like take them out too much and show you, but so the remote you can control and it'll pulsate an electric signal on your back, and it's just like a pain relief technique. I don't know if it will work for me or if it will help me, but our doula explained that just holding something and feeling like you can press something during contraction can be really helpful. So I was like, yeah, sure, I'll try it. I've really enjoyed doing this electric, I think it's called electric stem therapy. I could be totally wrong. Something like that. But I really enjoyed this when I was having back pain. I would sit and rest on the machine with like an ice pack. So I'm used to having this. So I figure it's something worth trying for labor. Then the only other thing I have for labor is a pair of Beats headphones that like totally cover the ear, and just a normal pair of iPhone headphones. I'm practicing hypnobirthing for this labor and delivery, and there are some meditative hypnosis kind of tracks that I have on my iPhone to listen to. And I also have a music playlist with some Jewish music that hopefully will be comforting to me, so I wanted to make sure to have two options for headphones. I have heard, by the way, that wireless headphones can be really helpful because then you're not like stuck among the wires. I didn't want to purchase them just just for this, maybe that's silly, but yeah, I guess I would pass on that recommendation because it does sound like it's worthwhile. And the last thing I have is just an extra charger because I really want to rely on those hypnobirthing tracks and stuff. I want to make sure that my phone is charged. And then two last items I have. I don't know if I'll be allowed to eat. Again, it just depends on like where I'm laboring and how it's going, but I have trail mix that I got and some fruit snacks. So these are just like my favorite things to eat. They're super high calorie, but they don't require like actually eating a lot of them. So I think this will be good snacks to have on hand. And if I don't eat them during labor, I'm sure I'll eat them after. My husband will. So I'm happy to have these along with me. Oh, and then one last thing for labor and delivery. I have socks with like stickies at the bottom. These are actually from when I did bar class back in the day. But if you are walking around, they usually do require that you wear something like this. And so I just like having my own because the hospital ones are not that nice. Okay, then the next section of stuff I like to call my Instagram section. So these are all just like things that I am bringing with because I am on YouTube and Instagram and stuff. By the way, you should definitely follow me. It's at my Jewish mommy life. So I'm just bringing my Instax mini camera. This takes such cool pictures, just like unlike anything you can get on your phone. And sometimes I'll take a picture with my phone of these pictures and it just like kind of captures the moment in a really cool way. I'll link it below, but yeah, I just love this little camera. And then the last thing that really is just for pictures is this felt letter board. I got this on Amazon. I'll link it for you guys. I've used it a ton for taking pictures on Instagram and it's really nice. So we'll probably put like the birth date and the birth weight or something. So yeah, I'm not sure exactly what, but I've seen a lot of pictures on Instagram that use this for a newborn kind of first picture and I love them. So I'll be bringing this with as well. Okay, then moving along to toiletries. I am like the most low maintenance person ever. So I'm really bringing the bare minimum. Also, I am the last person to put on makeup in the hospital. Like, I actually, sometimes I see people like totally really made up and I'm just like, looks kind of strange to me. I don't know, I can't wrap my head around it. So again, these are just the bare necessities. My mother-in-law got me this Amica, I think it's pronounced, hairdryer. I freaking love it. It's so cute and little. And I was looking for a travel hairdryer and I love this one because it's just so tiny. And I did really dry my hair with it already just to like test it out and it was totally great. So yes, I love this. I'll be bringing that with. And then this is my little mini toiletry bag and in it I just have, I haven't actually filled them up yet, but a shampoo and conditioner bottle and two of these like refillable things. I'm just gonna put my face cream and some like, I have this like hair cream thing that I use, so I'll fill those two and that's like it in terms of like cosmetic stuff. The only thing for makeup I'm bringing is my mascara because there is like a newborn photographer that comes around the hospital. But hopefully I'll be in a good enough mood and position to put on some mascara if we get pictures taken. And then I just have a mini travel hairbrush, some lip balm because hospitals tend to be really dry, Aquaphor for the same reason, and then a hair, what's it called? A shower cap in case I don't want to go through the whole blow drying and shower and washing my hair thing, but I just need a quick rinse off. Then I have some eye makeup remover in case I head into the hospital with makeup on and I want to get rid of it. A bunch of hair ties. And then the last thing is my toothbrush. So that's it. That's everything that's in my toiletry kit. Okay, so for postpartum, let's start with the baby stuff because that's way more fun. I have this blanket from Pottery Barn Kids. This is like the receiving slash going home blanket. It's February right now and it's freezing cold on the East Coast, so I got kind of a thicker blanket just to like drape over the car seat. Then for clothes for the baby, this is way too many clothes. I 100% know that, but I just have no idea what size this baby is gonna be when he comes out. And some of these are like super tiny and some of them are not. So I just figured all in all, they don't take up that much space. I'd rather just have the option of something that fits and looks cute. So when my son was born, we pretty much, we just did skin to skin the whole time. Like I barely put him in any clothes. And then for the coming home outfit, it was like we took one picture in the car seat. It wasn't even that cute a picture. So I don't know like what the obsession is with all these clothes at the hospital. Also, my son was jaundiced and his skin was so yellow in those photos that we did barely shared any of them. So the only one we shared was him in his hospital blanket. But you know what? This time, hopefully, I'll be in the mood to dress this baby up and take a lot of pictures. So that is what I'm hoping for this time around. So I have this onesie. This is from Carter's. This is actually Max's old one. So I'm not sure if it's around anymore, but it's like little sheep. It's very fleecy and warm. So this will probably be the coming home outfit if it's still like 0 degrees outside like it is today. And I have two t-shirts from Carter's as well. These are size newborn. They fasten on the sides. So you're supposed to keep your baby in shirts before their umbilical cord falls off so nothing is like rubbing against it. And then the hospital, when we did put Max in clothes, he just wore these shirts with a diaper. So we'll probably be using those when like we're not taking pictures and just want like a plain shirt. And then I mentioned this on my Instagram. I got a bunch of clothes from my absolute favorite kids store, which of course is in Australia, but it's called Jamie K. I just think they have the most gorgeous things. I will link them below. So again, their sizing, like, so this is the newborn size, and as you can see, it really is tiny. So I don't know if the baby will like come too big to actually even wear that. So I just brought a few different options, 0 to 3 and newborn size, so that hopefully he'll fit in one of them and I can get a cute picture. So yes, I love these baby clothes. I do need to take the tags off and wash these, by the way. Then the last thing for baby is just two little pairs of socks. They're so cute. I got these actually at H&M. They had a great sock deal, so that's why I picked these up. Okay, then the next fun, exciting thing that we're bringing with that's not gonna be packed in the bag is Max's present from his baby brother to him. We got all this at the Disney store. Max is really into Disney right now, and we're kind of prepping because we're hoping to go to Disneyland this summer, so I've kind of been pushing it a little bit, if I'm being honest. So he has a Mickey and a Goofy stuffed animal that he sleeps with every night. So we just got him Pluto and Donald because he loves them as well. And then he absolutely loves the movies Cars. He's totally obsessed. Again, if you follow my Instagram, you would know that. So we got him Lightning McQueen's Mack truck in the small size. We have like this enormous Mack truck that he got for Hanukkah, but he doesn't have like a little one that he can carry around, so I think he'll love this. So I'm very excited for his little brother to give this to him. I know he will absolutely love it. Okay, then on to what I'm bringing for myself for postpartum. I'm bringing one nursing cover. What I love about this one is you just put it over your neck like a scarf, and then you can nurse the baby. You can wear it like this. It is also a car seat cover. Like, this thing does it all. And I just absolutely love it. I will confirm the brand when I link it below. I want to say it's Covered Goods, but I'm not 100%. But yes, this is my favorite nursing cover. And then I'm also bringing nipple shields. This is a highly controversial item, but I nursed my son up until he was 18 months. And I know from every lactation consultant and every midwife, etc., pediatrician, that I need to wear them. So again, if you want to know more about nipple shields, I advise you to look into them on your own. For the average person, I would not recommend it. I just know I need them to physically nurse, so that's why I'm bringing them. Then in terms of clothes, I'm bringing two pairs of compression socks. Again, this is a medical thing for me that I need to wear postpartum. Not everyone does, although I've heard it's actually just a good thing. I find them entirely uncomfortable and I hate them, but it's important to wear them, so I'm bringing them with. Then I'm bringing one pair of flip-flops for like the shower and just to walk around the hospital in. And then in terms of clothes, I'm really trying to not pack too much. So I'm bringing two pairs of just like lazy, super loose pants. I do not recommend bringing like leggings. These are much looser than leggings. They're like pajama pants. So a pair of black ones and a pair of gray ones. Then I'm bringing a pair of actual pajamas. These are my favorite ones. I've mentioned them before. They are in gray. I also have them in blue. They are by the brand Eberger. They're super nice. They are expensive, but I find them to be just the nicest pair of PJs out there. And what's really nice is they don't wrinkle, so I really appreciate that, and they're really, really soft. So I will link them below again, but yeah, my favorite pajamas. And I did treat myself to a new set for postpartum, because I think I deserve it for that. And then other than that, I'm just bringing a cardigan in case it's a little bit chilly, although from my experience, the labor and delivery wards are just always hot. And then two t-shirts, These are both Lululemon in gray. This one's a long sleeve and then a short sleeve of the same exact kind. I like live in these t-shirts, so I love them. They're very soft and very comfortable. And the last thing I have is just a nursing tank top to wear underneath everything. I don't know if I'll actually end up putting this on. I probably will just wear nothing under, but it's nice to have the option if I'm feeling good or for going home to put this underneath. So that is everything I'm packing in my hospital bag. Stay tuned for a montage of me getting all this in there. The only other two things I'm bringing with to hospital that I don't think are gonna fit in the bag is a towel, because the towels they have for showering are these like thin little cloths. And then my own pillow from home. I need to change the pillowcase on this and put it aside. Right now, this is the one from our bed. But I do want to have my own pillow because, again, it's just more comfortable. It's not a necessity. It's just a nice thing to have. So I hope you guys like this. Stay tuned. You're about to see a speed up of me packing all this in. Hopefully it all fits. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. I'll see you next time. Bye.